help is needed, and it's needed fast. Barely a day goes by without another reminder of the crisis in our healthcare system. Doctors, nurses, and the hospitals they work in barely coping with staff shortages and burnout. But could the answer lie on the battlefields of America's culture wars? Will dissatisfied and terrified US medical specialists come our way? Here's Mark Kreisel, and a warning, images and themes in the story could be upsetting.
Hey, God gave you that baby, don't kill it.
This is illegal and you're a lawbreaker.
Stark lines have been drawn. In America's culture war. When politics, health, and religion clash.
Please help us, Lord, to love one another more fully and to respect and value everyone on earth.
Honestly, never thought they would take away women's rights or autonomy over their body.
Sundays on the front lines.
So here we go, a clinic compound.
Anti-abortion extremists are terrorists.
How can you get more criminal than the people that are willing to cut the heads and legs and arms off of little baby humans?
Where women have lost the right to choose.
It's illegal to have any abortions. Doctors are fined $100,000. They can go to prison.
Today, we're going to be talking about working and living in New Zealand.
But many of America's doctors and nurses are now making a different choice, and that is to leave.
Is the pain of America's abortion debate New Zealand's gain?
I don't think I have a place here. I think my soul needs a break, honestly.
When would you like to see American nurses and doctors here?
Yesterday.
Do you just want to mute your Apple?
Oh, sorry.
Prudence Thompson's emails from America just don't stop.
These are more people.
Yeah.
Contacting you.
Yeah.
Prue's a former nurse who runs Accent.
She's going to be fantastic for theatre.
A global medical recruitment firm out of Christchurch.
Yeah, we'll set up a Skype call. We've got nurses, physios, OTs, general physicians, family physicians, psychiatrists, and they're frightened, they're terrified at work, and I think they're looking for an out.
I mean, this is crazy. You're still getting, as we speak, messages from people wanting to come to New Zealand.
Yeah.
And the exact date the emails avalanche started is etched in her brain.
24th, 25th June, our inboxes started pinging. People who really valued the importance of the body and their rights.
The 24th of June is the day the US Supreme Court overturned its 1973 Roe versus Wade decision, which had recognised the right to abortion. It immediately opened the door for individual US states to ban them. Abortions are now illegal in most of the southern states of America, the so-called conservative red states. The Lone Star State was one of the first to move.
She said, I've seen you in here before. I said, I've been here a time or two.
Welcome to the great state of Texas.
Y'all, happy to be here.
Texas has some of the toughest restrictions. You can openly carry a gun here, but you can't have an abortion. No exceptions for rape or incest. Nurses and doctors want out, and Prudence is on her way to meet them.
How much did inquiries go up when Roe versus Wade was overturned?
They probably quadrupled from the US overnight.
And what were they saying to you?
Just, how quick can I get there? What's the pathway? Are my skills needed? They want to know that New Zealand's going to be, a bit of a safe haven for them and their families moving forward. I'm as good once as I ever
was. What do you love about your job?
We have the sweetest, best patients. We have children that come here, so that's my favorite part, working with all the kids.
Marisa Coles is a Dallas pediatric nurse.
I'm not able to uphold the oath that I made of doing no harm and helping others.
That must be tough for a nurse.
Yeah. I just never thought they would take away women's rights or autonomy over their body. Never thought that would happen. Never, never, never.
But when they did, it came as a shock.
I feel uncomfortable talking about it.
Why is that?
Because you never know who's listening and who may disagree with you.
What does that mean, though, if somebody disagrees with you?
I could lose my job. I don't know. I just get nervous. Doctors get killed and nurses get killed. Like, they get scared. Yeah. Yeah.
Texas, her home state, is where the politics and religion of the abortion debate have trumped health and science.
Where I live is the epicenter of all of this, and it's like sent shockwaves through the entire nation.
And it's to this epicenter that recruiter Prudence has come to meet Marisa, who lives in a new house in a new suburb on the outskirts of Dallas.
Hi, Marisa. So lovely to see you.
Oh, thank you for having us here. Hello,
at 34, she's considering a move to Christchurch and a nursing job there.
So we look at more than one opportunity. You can have more than one interview in private or public, North or South Island, East or West. Wow. But I think you'll fit in anywhere.
Yeah, a lot of options.
Yeah.
A little intimidating, but
yeah,
that's why I have you here to help me.
Oh, good.
Why are you thinking of going to New Zealand?
I feel like New Zealand has a lot of opportunities, and I like their policies. There's a lot of positives, so many positives, so.
But it's massive to just up sticks and leave the place you grew up in.
I'm able to move on, but yeah, Texas is my home and my soul.
It feels like you're mourning what you've lost here in your state.
Oh.
You feel like you're grieving.
I hate to say this, but it's like, yeah, it's all I know. And now it's not there anymore.
But there's something else here.
We're at Women's Health Center. How can I help you?
Over the past few months, Sunday's been talking to scores of American medical specialists, especially those specializing in women's health. And they're scared.
You know, I'm usually pretty much full steam ahead, but I, you know, yeah.
Don't want to go to jail.
I don't want to go to jail. I don't want, yeah. We gotta protect ourselves, so.
Dr. Jessica Rubino of the Austin Women's Health Center, about 3 hours east of Dallas.
So I would see anywhere from like 30 to 60 patients in a given day. I would say about half of those would have been consultations, the other half would have been abortions.
You need to be brave to be one of only 15 abortion clinics out of a population of 30 million. There were times when Jessica wore a bulletproof vest at work.
The more that the rhetoric around abortion gets into politics, the more protesters we'd have outside. And then, you know, as guns become more and more legal in Texas or are essentially, you know, open carry here, that was an issue that we had to worry about.
What do you say to the other side who believe that it's a life and you're taking a life?
Yeah. Essentially, I have a life in front of me. I have a patient. It's as pro-life as it gets. And once that patient has decided what's right for something that's inside of their physical being, I respect that. That's it.
The Texas abortion ban means she can no longer do her job.
I cannot intervene if it's a 12-year-old girl who has been sexually assaulted by her grandfather, which I had a few months before this ban went into effect. I cannot intervene if it's a patient who this is a desired pregnancy, but the fetus has no brain. I cannot intervene in a patient who is dying of kidney failure, and to have a pregnancy would absolutely kill her. None of it is okay. We're in a completely unacceptable situation.
The Austin clinic's still operating, but they can offer little more than reassurance to the women who come here.
And when did you find out?
I found out maybe last week.
Okay.
22-year-old Jacqueline is less than 6 weeks pregnant, but her and her husband don't want to keep the baby.
Were you able to get another ultrasound scheduled here in Austin?
No.
Okay, and why not?
It seems like
we can't show Jacqueline's face because she's scared of the consequences.
I'm terrified. It's hard. When I heard the overturning, I cried. It was just so unbelievable that our state thinks so little of women and they want to control us.
Under Texas law, private citizens can be awarded anything up to $10,000 for reporting anyone involved in an abortion.
I actually talked to my husband about this. Whenever I called here, they asked me if I wanted to terminate, and I was like, I don't know what to tell them. I don't know if they're going to prosecute me, right? Like, tell the police something or possibly go to jail, get a fine. Like, it's scary, the whole thing. You don't know what your consequences are going to be.
What are you going to do now?
I'm going to travel out of state to get an abortion.
When we come back, Jacqueline's journey.
In Kansas or Colorado, they weren't going to get me in until, like, November.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah.
Right.
And what awaits?
We have been systematically targeted by anti-choice protesters. This is a scary place to be.
New Zealand's healthcare system is on life support.
Capacity is 23 beds. And at the moment, we're at nearly 40 patients with patients in our ambulance bay waiting for beds, and our resus is full.
So it doesn't matter how much they pay you. You know, if you're tired, you're tired, and it's not safe to work.
Hospitals around the country at peak capacity.
It's always a juggle. Every single day, it's a juggle.
Barely coping with severe staff shortages.
That's good.
Yeah.
What about next week? How's that looking?
Christine Baxter, Christchurch Hospital Surgical Nursing Director. Are you short?
Yes. Every day. Every day.
How many do you need?
It's around 100, 120. So it's a significant vacancy.
No, my name is Prudence Thompson. We've come over from New Zealand, and this is the lovely Hannah.
Worldwide, an urgent recruitment drive is underway to fill thousands of those gaping holes.
So there is vacancies in all areas that we've never seen before, in general practice, private, public.
Recruiter Prudence Thompson has filled this room in Dallas, Texas, with American doctors, nurses and medical technicians hoping to lure them to New Zealand.
I just spoke to a wonderful medical oncologist. She just bought her ticket for the seminar yesterday, and she was on the fence, and I think we've tipped her over.
Come on.
Aotearoa can't pay them as well, but many feel they just don't belong in America anymore.
Was the decision to overturn Roe versus Wade a factor in you wanting to leave?
I was thinking about leaving before, but I think it kind of helped push the decision.
The abortion bans, the final straw.
I didn't cry, but I wanted to. I feel like we took a huge step back in this country when it happened.
I'm worried about the next thing you know, they're going to take the women's rights away for voting. It's just we have gone regressed far back in our history, and it's not pleasant. It's actually frightful.
But other than that, you're good to go. We'll see you tomorrow.
Nurses, obstetricians and gynaecologists on the front line of women's health in the southern states say they're devastated.
You're now in a position where getting pregnant is a very dangerous proposition.
Dr. Jessica Rubino of the Austin Women's Health Center.
If you don't want to continue the pregnancy, it doesn't matter either way. You're stuck with that pregnancy until the state decides that it's okay for it to be out of your body.
It's leading desperate women to consider desperate and dangerous decisions.
I have had patients saying that they're taking, like, drinking bleach. I've had patients saying they're trying to use objects or having people punch them in the stomach. These are physical things that are very dangerous. So is this your first ultrasound?
There is another choice, traveling interstate to get a legal abortion.
Now you go ahead and sit up. So obviously a pregnancy is like, it keeps going, right? Like we have to do something, so it's a time thing.
Yes.
Yeah.
Very time sensitive.
18 of the southern states have abortion bans, but amongst that sea of red states, there are safe havens where women can still legally terminate their pregnancies. New Mexico, Colorado, and Kansas.
In Kansas or Colorado, they weren't going to get me in until like November.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
Right.
22-year-old Jacqueline is nearly 6 weeks pregnant, but doesn't want to keep the baby.
It kind of seems impossible to be able to do it here in Texas. I talked about it with my husband, and he supports me in whatever I choose to do. He says it's my body. But it's hard. It's been hard to come to that conclusion.
That hard conclusion is to travel out of state to one of the safe havens.
It has been devastating. Really, really devastating to just see that a woman's right has just been stripped away, you know, not just for me, but for other women who have worse scenarios than me, possibly rape, incest, things like that. Just knowing that they don't have that resource anymore, or they have to do what I'm doing now to extend the pregnancy that they don't want, is just so sad.
I think our nearest border is somewhere around 7 hours-ish, you know? So this is not, you know, that's not a safe situation.
And yet, often on their own, quietly and anonymously, they hit the road.
As Jacqueline told us, many Texan women are now leaving the state to get an abortion. We're driving to Wichita in Kansas. That's pretty much the length of the South Island. But for many, this is the only choice they have left.
I have to say, get out of the state. Something completely inappropriate as a physician. Traveling when you're pregnant also increases your risk of complications.
It's about 6 hours down a gun barrel highway through the fading lights of the Bible Belt just to get to Oklahoma.
That entire journey is anxiety-ridden, and to get out is huge.
Abortion's illegal in Oklahoma from the point of conception. There's still a ways to go to get to a safe haven. We drive on and on through the night. Song, song of the South, sweet potato pie, and I shut my mouth. Gone, gone with the wind, there ain't nobody looking back again.
So after 10 hours, we've finally arrived in Kansas. Behind us is Texas and Oklahoma, where abortions are illegal. But here in Kansas, a woman can have an abortion up to 22 weeks, but it comes at a cost, both financially and emotionally.
Turn right to South Hillside Street.
There are 4 abortion clinics in Kansas.
So here we go.
Our destination is the Trust Women's Clinic in Wichita.
A clinic compound.
Anyone driving into the Trust Clinic has to pass pro-life protesters and a van with a large graphic image of a dead baby.
People driving by that are concerned that that is what their abortion looks like, that that is what their pregnancy looks like, that is like a fully developed fetus on that truck.
Dr. Christina Bourne is the medical director.
So we're in the compound now. We can't film inside the clinic. Why is that?
Well, we generally discourage filming inside the clinic because of how much of a target we are. So we want patients and staff members to be safe inside the clinic.
They write down registration numbers?
They write down license plate numbers, which might be registration numbers. They film people coming in and out. They yell at people coming in and try to give them information.
When you get inside, what, metal detectors, security guards, the whole thing?
Yeah, unfortunately, yes, for patients.
That threat is frighteningly real.
It has been flooded. It's been car bombed. It's had multiple other like bombing attempts.
Does it sometimes feel like you're at war?
Oh, absolutely, yeah. These people are terrorists. They spread misinformation and they spread fear.
Terrorism, it's a strong word.
Mm-hmm. They are not pro-life. They often wish for our death. They wish for the death of people who are seeking abortions and are very unapologetic about it.
In 2009, Dr. George Tiller, a previous medical director at Christina's clinic, was shot and killed by an anti-abortion extremist as he entered this Wichita church to pray.
We don't come to clinic alone. There's recommendations that, like, as physicians, we wear bulletproof vests. There's recommendations that I travel with like armed security guards.
It means the clinic feels more like a military bunker than a medical facility.
The vast majority of folks are like tired, stressed, scared, and also like, but still coming here for the care that they need.
Care that'll cost them in New Zealand dollars between $1,000 and $4,000.
We spoke to a woman in Texas, Jacqueline. She wanted to come to this clinic. How many Jacquelines are there?
There are thousands, tens of thousands of Jacquelines. We're one of, like, very few places in the Midwest and the South where you can get an abortion.
Coming in their droves from abortion ban states like Texas and Oklahoma.
We will never be able to meet the demand here in our clinic. We get upwards of like 100 calls an hour, and we have 40 appointments a day for one physician clinics. For our rare times where we have two physician clinics, we can see about 60 people.
How are your staff coping with all that extra work?
The system was set up to collapse, so we're doing our best to like uphold a breaking system, but truly I worry about like capacity to continue going.
The front line of women's health in the anti-abortion states. Do they stay or will they go?
So we're going to be talking about the requirements for working in New Zealand and a little bit about the healthcare market.
Many of the American doctors and nurses in this room are coming our way.
I would say over the next 2 years, at least 3/4 of these people will come to New Zealand.
Clean air, a fresh start, some new friends.
Venture and just hearing the work-life balance, I need that. Just spend the rest of my life there, actually. Really looking forward to it.
Red state nurses, obstetricians, gynaecologists, America's healthcare specialists are making their choice.
My plan is to leave the country.
Dr. Jessica Rubino is heading to London.
America has hurt itself. Politicians have hurt us for decades, for an entire generation. I mean, it's what has happened to us is devastating.
Really hemorrhaging qualified providers who have studied for years and years and want to help women, and we're losing them. That's scary.
Nurse Marisa Coles from Dallas is leaving too.
I don't want to work in a system that treats people like this, treats their medical staff like this.
From America to Aotearoa.
Why New Zealand?
New Zealand seems to be very balanced. They support women and people's bodies, having autonomy over their bodies. So, yeah, I like that.
One American pediatric nurse, or Marisa, wants to come and work in Christchurch. Would her skill set be?
Absolutely. Absolutely. Look, we'd welcome her. We have vacancies across all our areas, and we know that international nurses bring a huge amount of experience. And, you know, that diversity in our workforce is huge. So tell her to get in touch. We'd love to hear from her.
Well, a recent survey shows more than 2 million women in America's abortion ban states now have no access to obstetric care. New Zealand medical recruiter Prudence Thompson is on Breakfast tomorrow morning, highlighting immigration difficulties that are keeping US medical staff from moving here.